for growth and development. No, you put them in the area of their competence. But you don't give people tasks that are too easy. Otherwise, they will never grow. So the person can tackle something up to this in his area of competence. You give him a task like that. You leave room for growth and development. So that as he's tackling the thing, it's not too easy. But those difficult areas are what makes him to grow. The next time he would have grown to this level, he's no longer at this level because he has tackled some. But if you give him an area where he's not competent, he will be completely frustrated. He doesn't know what to do. He doesn't know how to do it. You say you like somebody, you just want to, you know, you want to inspire him. You tell him to go and fly a plane. He will be frustrated. He's been driving car all his life. You tell him to go and fly a plane. Doesn't even know where to start. He can't. That's not a challenge. That's destroying him. So that's important. So we must give people, and that's managing people. That means that as a leader, you are studying people. You are looking at when they do things, where they are good, what they are good at, so that you can be able to help them to grow in that area. So you manage them. This person is very good with teaching. This individual is good with singing. This individual is very good with visitation. He cares a lot. When you are starting a new church, those are the people to put in together as a team. So you have somebody, when he preaches, the church is edified. You have another person, when he or she leads choruses, everybody, you know, their hearts are lifted up unto heaven. And yet, you have another person that, you know, cares about people, he can visit. So, diversity. Then that church planting team, or that church will grow. People say, we don't know, the church is just growing. Yes, because all the things you need are there. The person who can preach so that people can get knowledge and get inspired and get edified is there. The person who can sing well so that people get carried along, you know, in worship and they can enjoy worshiping God is there. People who cares about people, who can visit, who can phone, who can do this. If somebody is not in church, he will notice it. It's there. Why would that church not grow? But you go and put three teachers in the church. Oh, they will pastor two people for 10 years. Because church is more than teaching. Amen?
Amen.
You know, that's what some people say, we give them our best in the church, but they're all teachers. So one will teach the scriptures, the other one will teach. That church will never grow. He says, Satan, this Lord is not Satan, you as a leader, you don't know what to do. You have not managed, empowered leaders very well. That's what we do. Managing people, managing leaders. Thank God God has empowered them. Thank God they are growing. We manage them very well. You put each person where he can function, where he can contribute, and where his contribution can make an impact. That's important. I pray the Lord will help us.
Amen.
So managing empowered leaders include assigning them tasks to which they are best suited and yet leaving room for growth and development, pairing them up with others with complementing skills, thereby enhancing their effectiveness. Paul is planting, Apollos can water. Peter and John going into the temple. One is quiet, the other one is one is an introvert, the other one is an extrovert. You know, so you balance it. John can easily go into depression, but Peter's, you know, outgoing nature will pull him. Peter can easily go astray, you know, very, very easy. But John's cool and calm nature will bring him down. So eventually you have a balance and they can go. That's how to manage. Providing avenues for them to express their gifts. Exodus chapter 4. You know, we can learn even in what God did. But when God does that a lot, pairing people together. Exodus chapter 4, verse 10. And Moses said unto the Lord, Oh, my Lord, I am not eloquent. Neither heretofore, nor since thou hast spoken unto thy servant, but am slow of speech and of a slow tongue. And the Lord said unto him, Who hath made man's mouth? Or who maketh dumb or deaf? Or seeing or the blind? Have not I the Lord? Now go, therefore go, and I will be with thy mouth, and teach thee what thou shalt say. And he said, Oh my Lord, send, I pray thee, by the hand of him whom thou will send. And the anger of the Lord was kindled against Moses. And he said, Is not Aaron with Levi thy brother? I know that he can speak well. And also, behold, he cometh forth to meet thee. And when he seeth thee, he will be glad in his heart. And thou shalt speak unto him, and put words in his mouth. And I will be with thy mouth, and with his mouth, and will teach you what ye shall do. And he shall be thy spokesman unto the people, and he shall be to thee instead of a mouth, and thou shalt be to him instead of
God.
Do you realize that God could have healed Moses' stammering?
Yes.
But God decided not to. What you need to do is to speak well. God said, okay, Aaron will be your partner. Before you go out, you plan all the strategy. What I've already revealed to you, you declare it, you speak to Aaron, you instruct him. When you get to the public, Aaron will take over. He can speak without stammering. Can you see complimenting there? Can you see complimenting there?
Yes,
this is God. See, what we need to do is to speak. All right, there's a way to do it. What you lack, I'll bring somebody else who has it. Put the two of you together, you're a winning team. And that's God. If God will do this, well, we need to imitate. We need to see beyond. You know, many times we read stories, and all what we read are just stories. We're not seeing the principles behind what God is doing. And that's what this kind of meeting does, to open your eyes, to see this is what God is doing. These are the principles that we learn, that we can put people together to complement whatever skills are lacking. That's also what God tries to do in marriage. Many times, you know, most marriages that collapse in the world, you know why? Because people that are like each other, they marry themselves. So they are good in one area and a bundle of mess in another area. And the area where they are a bundle of mess is always creating problems. Whereas what God wants to do is to so put people together that where I am weak, you are strong. Where you are weak, I am strong. So you create a structure that is always strong because there is reinforcement. But people in the world, I like going to party. I like going to party. I like watching movies. I like watching movies. And because of their similar interests, they marry themselves and they'll be fighting all the day because all the other things that they do, that's exactly where conflict will be rising every time. No. God is faithful. So in the church, the pastor needs to know, the regional overseer needs to know that empowered leaders still need to be managed. We need to be able to put two and two together to see the different diversities of gifts in our people and be able to see that if I put this brother and this sister in a particular team, because of these different gifts that they have, they can utilize that to move the church forward. It's not just putting people who are similar together. That doesn't produce anything. It doesn't produce the best. And I pray the Lord will help us.
Amen.
And people that don't know that, because they are empowered leaders, that they still need to be managed, you are gaining wisdom today. That even though you are empowered, thank God you have skill. Thank God you have gifts. Thank God God is using you. But you might still need somebody over you to be able to manage you, to be able to help you, to be able to put other people around you so that your gifts can shine, so that your talent can blossom, so that you can really be the effective leader that God is calling you to be. And I pray that the Lord himself will help in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Do you see the case of Jesus? Look at what he did. The disciples were very helpful. He multiplied bread and he's going to feed 1,000. But can Jesus do all? No. It's the disciples that did the distribution. The disciples that gathered the fragments together. The disciples that helped him to manage the crowd. His disciples that dispersed the crowd for him. He can't do it all, and he didn't do it all. He made sure that they did what they could do. They were in the boat. What was he doing?
He was sleeping.
Oh, was the boat moving by itself?
No.
Hey, but the disciples can do that, so why should he stay awake? You sleep. Let them do the rowing that they can row. He has been doing the talking all day. They've just been, so now they are strong, but he's been doing the preaching all day. He's tired, he can rest. Now, it's time for them, they can row up. Let's get to the other side. And they went. And in the church also, it must be like that. As a pastor, you can't do it all. Do the one you can do, and let the others do the ones they can do. Manage their gifts, manage their talent, manage the skills, and put everything together. The Lord will be glorified.
Amen.
Let's rise up and pray. And let's tell the Lord he will help us. Effective leadership in the local church. This is the way to do it, my brother. This is the way to do it, my sister. Every pastor, this is what to do. Every leader, this is what to do. Effective leadership can be in our local churches. We must start with modeling it. We must start with exemplifying it. We must start with living it. Let people see. Model it.
In the name of Jesus. Apostle Lord. In the name of Jesus. But all these principles that you have given unto us, O Lord, we can choose them. We can choose them. O Lord, help us. O Lord, help us. Receive everything you want. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
Keep on praying, brother, my sister, keep on praying. And make sure that you pray and you pray too. Effective leadership in the local church. Effective leadership in the local church. Pray through my brother, my sister. And let me remind you so that you can be able to pray. He talked about, yes, modeling effective leadership. Modeling effective leadership, he said you can model them by your way of living, by your example, praise, by your example, by your way of living, you can model them. My brother, pray at this moment. And I used to say from the scripture, like Paul wrote to the Corinthian church, he says that, look, the husbandman must be the first partaker of the fruit. The husbandman must be the first partaker of the fruit. What are you expecting? What do you want to see, my brother, in the leaders, in the people under you? What do you want to see in their life? What do you want to see in their life? What do you want to see in their life? My brother, you must be the first partaker of it. You must be the first partaker of it. You must be the first partaker of it. Pray at this moment and tell the Lord. You expect the leaders, the people under you, the members under you, not to come to church late. You must be the first partaker of it. You are looking at them that, yes, they will evangelize. You must be the first partaker of it. You are looking at it that, yes, they will be their brother's keeper. My brother, you must be the first partaker of it. Show an example. Be an example, my brother. You are looking at that, yes, they will pray. They will intercede for other people. My brother, be the same as well. Pray and call upon the Lord. Pray and call upon the Lord that the Lord himself will help. The Lord himself will help. The Lord himself will help. You're expecting that, yes, the brethren, the congregation, my brother, they will be merciful. They will care for one another. Be the first partaker of that fruit, that expectation. Be the first partaker of it. Let them see it in your life. Pray, 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 pray. Pray unto the Lord. 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 You should be able, my brother. You should be able, my sister. You should be able to tell other people that what you see me doing, do the same. But the question is, what are they seeing in your life? What are they seeing in your life? What are they seeing in your life? Don't be like the Pharisees who tell them, they say that, look, do as I say, but don't do as I do. You know? Don't look at the things that I'm doing. Because they do the opposite. What they say, they do the opposite. What they say, they do the opposite. My brother, pray that the Lord himself will help. That you'll be the first partaker of that fruit. Pray and call upon the Lord at this moment. And the man of God told us, we can be effective leaders in the local church by mentoring the emerging leaders. Mentor them, mentor them, mentor them, mentor them, mentor them, teach them. My brother, train them. Pray and call upon the Lord that the Lord himself will help those who are coming up. Train them, teach them, show them, my brother. Lead them, guide them what to do. Pray, 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 pray. Open their eyes, my brother. Lead them and guide them. Mentor them. Train them. Expose them, my brother, to the thing they ought to do. Help them, my brother. Help them, my brother. Help them, my brother. Sisters, you can do the same. Help them. Effective leadership in the local church. Effective leadership in the local church. Pray, 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 pray. Are you teaching the people under you? Are you teaching the people under you? Are you training the people under you? What to say, what to do, how to act, how to behave, how to comport themselves. Are you doing it? Are you doing it, my brother? Are you doing it? Pray and call upon the Lord. Our God is able. Pray and call upon the Lord. Our Lord is able. Pray and call upon the Lord. Our God is able. Call upon his mighty name, my brother. He will help. He will help. He will help. Pray, 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 pray. And those who already they have emerged as leaders, you can still manage them. The man of God told us, we can still manage them, my brother. You can still manage them. Pray that the Lord himself will help. Pray that the Lord himself will help. Pray that the Lord himself will help. In the name of Jesus, call upon the Lord at this moment. Pray and tell the Lord. 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 The Lord is able. Our great God and King is able. Our Savior is able. In the name of Jesus, pray and tell him at this moment. The Lord will do it. The Lord himself will do it. The Lord himself will do it. The Lord will help us. The Lord will help us. The Lord will help us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
I pray God, we thank you, we bless your name.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, you have been so merciful and kind unto us.
Amen.
Lord, you have been so good to us.
Amen.
By exposing this very truth unto us.
Amen.
Lord, we bless your great name in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Lord, it's all about doing. It's not only hearing. It's all about doing. And I pray that that which we have heard, Lord, we will do it in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Then we begin, my Lord God and King, to put it into practice.
Amen.
At the end of the day, it's only through that that we can be blessed.
Amen.
It's not only the hearers. I pray, King of all kings, will not be forgetful hearers concerning these things in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Lord, all we ask for is more grace.
Amen.
And I pray that as we receive the grace, that grace also will not be in vain in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. We thank and we bless you.
Thank you.
In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We are still praying. We are still praying. And at this moment, we're still going to continue in our series of praying. Remember,